friendships, and otherwise, it means a whole lot. Like I talked about earlier during the toast, you all mean a very special deal, and we can always learn from each other. So thank you all for your influence there. So my Air Force family, the people who were here earlier with the 100 Black Men of America, I have a distinct honor and privilege as an ordinary man, being an extra-regular guy to work with a lot of extraordinary kids that you saw today. So I'm very honored and privileged to be called one of their mentors. So having said that, it's not about us sometimes, right? It's about the others whom we can help. And those people mean a lot to me as well. And I'm just speaking from my side. I know Bunnell has stuff to say for her side. But particularly my family, Jazz, I want to highlight you. I think she went to the bathroom, but I'll get her when she comes back. Love you all so much. Thank you all for being here. To the vendors, DJ Tripp, Emer, great job tonight. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Miss Ann Harper, wedding hostess that you saw at the ceremony earlier. CPix Photography, thank you for the photo booth. The Langley staff, didn't get a chance to congratulate them. Now that I've done this real time, I'm learning lessons like, oh yeah, I should have congratulated the staff before they departed. But great job on their part as well. Yvette's Creations for the cord that you see in there. I just learned that term because I watch HGTV with Mel. So everyone that had a part in this, please don't hold it against me if I miss anyone. Blame it on my mind, not my heart. Been up for a long time today, and it's been a long week, as you can imagine, so hopefully this comes out clearly. And I'm rambling a little bit now, but I've been told I don't speak a whole lot, but when I speak a whole lot. So go figure that out. Okay, no, that's fine. So, and I really wanted to close before, I'll mention it for Jasmine, because I don't know if she'll come back in time. To the staff, thank you.
Woohoo! Yay!
Thank you all so much, fantastic job. And the catering staff, Ms. Charmin's staff. My niece Jasmine, very, very special part. And as some would say, you are humbly proud, right? Pride. Sinful pride in context. We are all humbly proud of her. There she is. Jazz, come in here. She's like another little part of me. So this is my lovely, sweet, intelligent 11-year-old niece. And we're also very proud of her, humbly, seeing you develop into the young lady that you are. All those attributes and the claims that I mentioned, but mostly a good kid. And love you so much. Thank you for being here. I know you make your parents humbly proud, your grandparents, and on both sides. And just thank you all so much for your part. Like I said, Wayne, Taj, Kurt, Dap, see who else, Jazz, Mom, Dad, love you. Thank you for the influence. Family, Harrell family, this doesn't just happen by accident, right? Someone giving the toast earlier kind of alluded to family and their influences and your impact on us and our lives and our development and maturity. Let me be upfront. So this day and age, we seem to have lost a lot of good parenting. I'll just say that, right? We've seen it out in our neighborhoods and so forth. But from what this young lady brings, I thank you for your part in that, because this just doesn't happen. I hit the jackpot, right? And segue to that, my party, quickly, Francisco Guerrero, FJG, aspiring rapper once upon a time. So I met Francisco August 21st, 1999, summer orientation, University of Georgia, freshman orientation. The first guy whom I met at UGA in orientation, right? Who knew that math and public when you're tired, 18 years later, right?
Yep.
Good grief. That he would be a part of my wedding party, you know? Quiet guy, saw him then. Yeah, man, where are you from? Alabama? Oh, yeah, I've been to Alabama. Mobile. He's like, nah, I'm from Huntsville. Yeah, Mobile's like, all right, cool. Man, Marquise Haynes. Met Marquise through Francisco at a basketball game in UGA. You know? You never think that kind of stuff. Anna, thank you for sharing Francisco with me. Jamie, thank you for sharing Marquise with me. You guys mean a whole lot. Dwayne, brother-in-law, thank you for being a part of the party as well. Jeff, Carell family, all of you guys, thank you so much. You mean a whole lot. And I talked about all of your influences on myself, and also for this young lady, brings me to her. First off, you look astonishing, ravishing, beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. And I told you when I first met you that I thought you were too good to be true. I still think you're too good to be true. And I said that to say this, I have absolutely no business, y'all, being up on the same stage, sharing a microphone with this lady. No business at all. It's often said that water seeks its own level, right? In relationships, typically the same. But in this case, I married up, way up. So in that case, somebody has to take an L, and I'm glad to say it's not me. So Linnell, where that L? You married a little bit below your level, but I'm okay with that, because that means I'm winning. You're amazing. I couldn't have asked for a better mate, wife. Thank you so much for what you mean to me. I can only hope and pray that I will be everything that I'm commanded to be for you as your husband. Continue to grow in spiritual maturity with you. And I love you so much. So thank you for loving me. I don't know why you do, even. I don't even know why you like me sometimes. I know my family, because that can be difficult. They're over there in their amen corner, like, yeah. All right, that's enough. But in all seriousness, I thank you for putting up with some of my quirks and my mood swings. And just thank you for loving me. Like the song Major was played, this is why I love you, because you love me. And I thank you for having the patience to love me. I love you dearly, and I hope and pray that we continue to grow together. And once again, I hope that I can be the man that I'm supposed to be for you. Love you, baby. So.